Now let's see how to create the reusable component. Here I have taken the example of creating a button. In order to create the component, just do the right click. Here you can see the create component option. Either you can use the shortcut Ctrl+Alt+K. So you will get the pop-up. Here you can give the component name. So by default, you get it as variant. Here on clicking, we can change the name. And we have the options of hover or pressed. And also we can able to create another variant. At first, let me create the hover option. Now I wish to change this color to white. So in order to check this, I'm previewing this and hover, it's changing color. So we have created a button with the hover state. And also we need the another variants of buttons. Let's see how to make that. Here we have an option of variant. So on clicking, the variant 2 will be created. Here we can change the name. And I'm doing the changes that is needed for the second variant of button. So that I have created the second variant of this button, let me preview this. So you can able to see the changes. You can view the created component here. So for the option, you can see the different types of variant. We have created primary and secondary. So based on our design, we can change this variant type. We want to change the content of the button. Let's see how to make that. If I click on this text, under the text option, you can view the content. So on clicking, I can set the existing variable or create a new variable. Let me create a new variable in order to explain it more. So if I click on plain text, a variable will be created. Let me give it as text. And also by default, we can give the default value. Even we can give the placeholder, or even we can make it as text area or no. So the new variable will be created. To explain the variable mode, consider a box with a variable name. Inside that box, we can put the values which is related to the variable. I'm coming back to the home. Here we can see the button component. And coming to the right panel, we can see the variant which is created. And inside the text, we can change the text as we need, so that you can see the text has changed. So this is the basics of creating a component. You can always walk through by checking out my other videos in the Framer Beginner tutorial playlist. Subscribe and hit the bell button so you won't miss anything. See you in the next section. I have uncovered detailed insight in my upcoming Beginner Framer friendly course. For additional information, check the link in the description below.